Welcome to CO230, Introduction to Telecommunications, presentation about the Hamming code. Hamming code is a method of correcting errors when transmitting zeros and ones. So when binary data is transmitted, sometimes zeros turn into ones by mistake. Let's say this is a wireless transmission and the microwave goes on, and some zeros will be turned into ones, and they will look like corrupted data on the receiving end. This corruption might take place in a cable, or even when data is read into memory. These types of codes are necessary to validate and then repair the zeros and ones that can be corrected. So Hamming code was developed by Richard Hamming, who is a scientist, or was a computer scientist, who contributed greatly to this field. He worked at the Bell Telephone Laboratories in the 1940s, and he was working with some early computers and punch cards. And so as you were feeding the punch cards, which basically were feeding zeros and ones into the computer, if the computer misread a zero for a one or the other way around, then you would have to start everything all over. So Richard Hamming was working on this project of how to better enter data into computers and how to feed it better into the computers and how to empower computers to perhaps even correct, self-correct some of those errors. So Richard Hamming contributed things like the Hamming code, the Hamming window, Hamming numbers, the sphere packing, as well as the Hamming distance. So let's take a look at how Hamming code works. In our example, we're going to take binary data of 0110, and this data is going to be the piece that we're trying to communicate. Then we're going to add parity, and these parity bits are going to allow us to protect and then repair zeros and ones if they should be corrupted or changed. So first, let's talk about parity. What is parity? Well, parity is a method of validating that zeros and ones in a particular sequence have not been changed. Let me give you an example. Let's say that in this example we have 1111, we have four ones and three zeros. Even parity would require that there's even number of ones. Therefore, to validate this sequence of zeros and ones, we would add zero, because there's already an even number of ones. If we have another set of numbers, and this time we're going to have an odd number of ones, we would add, as the even parity, we would add a one. So now we have an even number of ones. So when the receiving end endpoint reads in this data, it can validate that yes, with this valid parity, this is a consistent piece of data, and we're hoping it came in without changes. Of course, parity works only if one bit at a time is getting changed. If more than one bit gets changed, then you will need something more advanced, something like the Hamming code, which we'll discuss in just a moment. Okay, so let's take a look at how the Hamming code works now that we've discussed parity. In our set of data, we're going to try to transport 0110. And in binary, of course, this is a place of a 0 or a 1, so it's 2 to 0 power. And this space right here would be 2 to the first power. In our example here, there is a 1 in this place, so in decimal system, this would represent number 2. This one represents 2 to the second power, or number 4. And these are two zeros, so 4 plus 2 is 6. So this right here represents 0110, represents in decimal system number 6. Okay, so this is the data we're trying to transport. And we're going to write in the data into this Venn diagram. We are writing the data by first selecting data space 1, and that's where our first 0 goes. This is data space 1. Then data space 2, and that's our 1. So this is D1, D2, D3, and finally D4. This is our D1, this is D2, this is D3, and this is D4. So 0, 1, 1, and a 0. This is the data. And now we're going to use parity to create additional numbers. These numbers are going to validate, or they're going to protect, the rest of the message. So parity 1 is going to protect 001. And the even parity requires that we use 1 in this space. So 0, 0, and 1, to have even number of 1s, we have to add a 1. Next, in parity space 2, so this is parity space 1, parity 2, we have 0, 0, and 1, therefore we add a 1. And finally, in parity 3, we have 1, 0, 1, and therefore we add a 0 to have even parity. So this is what the message would look like when it is being protected by Hamming code. In just a minute, we'll see what happens if there is a problem, an error creeps in, how this system protects its data. But for now, let's go ahead and write out this code in a sequence, in this Hamming code sequence. So first we start with parity 1 space, and parity 1 space has right now 1, so that's right here, parity 1. Then we follow by parity 2, which has a 1. Then we follow by the first data piece, which is a 0. Then we follow by the third parity, which is also a 0. Then we follow by the second data piece. The second data piece is a 1. The third data piece, which is a 1, is also, and the fourth data piece, which is a 0. That's the one in the middle. So this would be the sequence that gets transported over the wire. Now, let's, for example, change one of the numbers. We're going to take this 1, and we're going to create, instead of that, an error. Okay, this error here is going to be a 0. So, let's say this is a wireless transmission, and there is an electric microwave that goes on, the magnetic field, electromagnetic field creates interference, and now our receiving end interpreted the signal as a 0. So let's see how the parity will protect, and in fact how it can correct this issue, just like a self-riding sailboat. Okay, we start with the first circle, and this parity bit protects the 0, 0, and 1. This parity bit is correct because we have two 1s and they're even in the first circle that we are processing. And let's call this circle A. In circle B here, we have 0, 0, 0, and 1. Well, that is incorrect. That means circle B has a problem. The parity is not correct. But that's not yet enough information for us to correct this error. It's enough for us to detect it, maybe flag the transmission so it's resent. And then we have the third C circle, and in this circle we have only single 1. Well, that is an odd number of 1s, therefore the parity indicates this is incorrect. So now we can look at the crossroads of the circles, and since only B and C are reporting a problem, that means everything inside of A is correct. And the problem exists inside of the D2 space, because B and C both report a problem. Therefore, we have enough information here to go ahead and correct this error. This is not a zero. This, in fact, should be a one. And when this is a one, all the parities now agree, because here we have now one. In circle B, we have one and a one. Therefore, this is an even parity. And in C, we have two ones. And it's again even parity, and therefore we add a zero. Okay, so this is how a single change can be detected and corrected. In this Hamming code 7-4, which means that we're sending total of 7 bits, and we send 1, 2, 3, 4 bits of data. When we do that, we can detect and correct a single bit change, but then we can also detect 2 bits of change, which regular parity would not be able to detect. We may not be able to correct two bits of change, but we can detect it, which oftentimes means that we can, again, re-request the transmission. Okay, so this is a presentation about Hamming code version 7.4, indicating 7 bits of a code word, and then 4 bits of data. Thank you.